both of us were a little shocked at how little activity, artistic activity there was in Montreal. And especially for me, what I really found, and I think it's true to this day, there's not a lot of cross-pollination among the arts. But I think that both of us had the idea then, well, if it's not here, let's make it happen here. And that's when we started to really getting involved in presenting concerts here in Montreal.
It also gave us the possibility of continue my dream of promoting music from the three Americas. So doing Canadian and American music, it was going together with Central American composers or South American composers. So I was leading the life of the teacher in academia and the life of the performer, traveling performer, and organizing of groups and concerts within the faculty. And I was the director of the electronic studio for the next 35 years.
And then there were also kind of standalone events, you know, we'd go to a festival in Venezuela or whatever.
Mexico.
And at the same time, I was having children and, you know, juggling that, you know, having babies. And
how do you do that?
With difficulty. But you do it. I mean, he's in music 24/7. And I am not. You know, for me, the art is a component part of my life, but it's not my whole life. But for Alcides, it's really his whole life. If he's not writing music, he's listening to music, he's thinking about music.
The children, like marbles, tumble into life.
If I am composing, it means that I am composing at all times for, I don't know, 2-6 months a year. I live with the music, and I do the erasing, the writing and rewriting, all in my head.
All bodies, all hands.
So when I sit down, it used to be so funny with our kids, you know, kids can be very noisy. And sometimes the mother would say, or someone, oh, Papa is composing, be quiet, because I am at my desk with my ink pens and all that. And I say, no, just do all the, I'm copying, I'm not composing, the piece is finished.
And the children's eyes are stories with little magnets attached.
His compositional life integrated very well, in a way, with the family life. But I think it's fair to say that any artist lives in his own head quite a bit. And I think at the beginning, he was a little reluctant to have children. You know, oh, I've had children, you know, I'm 40, I'm not sure I want to do this anymore. And I said, well, that's what you get for marrying somebody 22 years younger. Too bad for you. So we decided to have children, and I decided to have them one at a time. In other words, how'd it go? Okay, I can have another one. Oh, yeah, three is good.
At night, the mothers come out of their shadows to collect the eyes the children have left like objects all over the block. The children's eyes. The things.
So I think it's just, it's a fact that, you know, after living together so long and working together so long, there's a shorthand. You don't need to be in the room. He knows exactly what it's going to sound like when he writes this for me. It's a very close relation. It's very hard to say who does what, but it's also very defined as far as I don't tell him how to compose, and he doesn't tell me how to perform.
Rodando como bolitas.